this is the run SQL command line is there. I'm going to click on this. So it will open this black window. Now what I'm going to do, I'm just going to click on this properties and I'm going to change the color and all. So I'm just going to change the color and the screen text I'm going to give and the font I'm going to give, and that's it. So now the things get changed. So first of all, what we need to do, we need to connect with the user. How we can connect with that user? I'm just going to write connect and my user was Scott Tiger. So I'm just going to connect with Scott Tiger. I'm just going to connect with the Scott Tiger. And you are also familiar with the spool command. So I'm just going to use the spool command. So all the things will get, we will get the notes and all, everything. So spool e colon slash oracle third session dot txt. CLSCR clear screen. If I'm going to write the command select star from EMP, we are getting the screen like this, like the result is coming like this. What we can do, we can arrange the data like this. So what we can do, we can use set line size. Set line size, that we can do. Now, other than this, what we can do, like here we are getting the page, we are having the page size, the page break is there. So what we can do, we can simply write set page size. I'm simply going to write set page size 25. Yeah, now it's perfectly fine. So in the previous command, it was about the select statement. So how we can use the select statement? This is the most important thing. Like I'm going to use select star from EMP. We are getting the data from the EMP table. I just want to display the name and salary. So what I'm going to do, I'm just going to write select ename comma sal from EMP. So we are getting the name as well as the salary. Suppose I'm going to write select ename comma sal from EMP where salary greater than 2000. So we are going to get all those records whose salary is more than 2000. I just want to put the alias name over there, so I'm just going to write select ename as name, sal as salary. So I'm just going to put the alias name over there. It's not going to make any changes with the table, it's just for the display. For the alias name, it's not necessary to use the keyword as, we can ignore this. Yeah, perfectly fine. Suppose I'm going to use select ename comma sal as salary from EMP. Now in the previous command it was about the order by salary. It will display the data in ascending or in descending order. Like I'm going to use order by salary DESC, it will put all the data in descending order. Suppose I'm going to use select ename comma sal comma commission comma sal plus com as total underscore sal from EMP. So we are getting the total salary. Some mistake is there, so I'm just going to check it out. Yeah, ename is there, salary is there, commission is there, and the total salary is there. So we are getting the name, we are getting the salary, we are getting the commission, and we are getting the total salary. But the problem is, this is the problem. The problem is we are getting the null values. Why we are getting the null? Number plus null, we are getting null. It's number plus null, again we are getting the null. So how to solve this problem? What we can do, we can apply the NVL function. So I'm just going to write NVL of com comma 0. Now it's perfectly fine. NVL is what? It's a null value, it's a function. It's going to replace the null value with 0. So 800 plus 0 is equal to 800. I also want to display the 0 in the place of null. So what we can do, we can write NVL we can write NBL of com comma 0 comma 0. Yeah, it's perfectly fine. So in the previous command, these command in the previous session, these command was there. How to apply the select statement, how to apply the where condition. With the where condition, the few other things was there, like select star from EMP, where enum like a percentile. So we are getting the name record whose name is going to start with A. Suppose I'm going to write percent, this is called wildcard. Suppose I'm going to use percentile S, it will display those record whose last character is S. See, we are having the S. Suppose I'm going to write select a star from EMP where cell between 3000 and 5000. So we are getting all those record where cell in between 3000 and 5000. So this is how we can use the select statement. In the previous session, these things was there. Now today we are going to start with the next topic. It's again the select statement is there, and first of all we are going to start with the group function. Group function is also known as aggregate function. And what exactly the group function or the aggregate function is? This function works on group and return single value. These functions works on group and return single value. Like I'm going to use select max of cell from EMP. So we are going to get the maximum salary. So this max function is going to work for the entire salary, and then it's going to give you the maximum salary among them. Suppose I'm going to use select mean of cell, we are getting the minimum salary. So this is the group function, or known as aggregate function. Suppose I'm going to use select sum of cell, we are getting the sum of the salary. Suppose we are looking for the count star, I'm just going to put count star, it's going to display the number of record. So we are having the number of record called 14. Suppose I'm going to use average of cell from EMP, so we are getting the average cell. So we are having the max function, mean function, sum function, count function, average function. So these are the different functions we are having that we can use. Now I'm going to use select count star comma, I'm going to use select count of com comma, I'm going to use count 1 from EMP. What will be the output? Yes, please. What will be the output? Any answer, any guess from your side? If I'm going to write count star, what it will display? 14. And if I'm going to count com, then what it will display? And we are having count 1. Enter this. Oh, interesting. Select star from EMP. So we are having the imply name commission. 1, 2, 3, 4. Oh, interesting. If I'm going to put count of com, it's just going to count this, it's not going to count the null value, and that's why we are getting 4 only. And count star and count 1 is both the same, but count 1 is faster in compared to count star. Count star is always not good. Remember, performance wise, this always degrade the performance of the queries, because you are using count star. Count star means what? It will move like this, then it will count 1 again, it will move like this, because you are using count star. It will go for the each and every columns, it will go for the each and every column. So performance wise count star is not good. When we are going to use count 1, 1 means what? 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1, and finally we are having the 14. So remember, performance wise count 1 is always better in compared to count star. So if we are having the option for the count star, I will go with the count 1. I will never go with the count star. So always we need to remember one important thing, that we need to work on, like if I'm using count 1, it's always better in compared to count star. So it's matter of performance. So if someone is going to ask you how to improve the performance, this is the answer that you can give. What we can do in place of count star, we can use count 1. Count 1 is better. It's better in performance. It's better in performance because when you apply the count star, star means what? This one, 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 and finally you are going to get 1. Again, or if I'm going to use count 1 means what? 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, and finally you are going to get the 14. So count 1 is always better. What will be the output if I'm going to put count 2 or count 100? It's the same. People normally using count 1 as a standard. You can put any values over there. It's not going to make any difference because we are using the count. So count 1 is always, it's a standard that we need to remember. And the another thing is, one important point, like the group function. The group function, avoid null values. Oh, that's great. That's why we are using select count comp, count of comp from EMP, and what we are getting? We are getting 4. We are not getting 14 because group function always avoid the null values. It's clear about the group function. Why it's called group function? Because it works for a group and return single value. It works for a group and will return the single value. That's why it is called group function, number one. Number two, we need to understand, like group function always ignore the null values. Number three, we need to understand, like count cell and count commission, count star and count one. Always count one is better. So if we are going to get the chance to write something like count star, I will ignore the count star, I will go with the count one. So this is the group function. Now the next is, we are having group by. Group by is basically for what? For grouping of similar kind of data. Group by is basically for grouping of similar kind of data. Like I am telling you, like I want to make the group, like right now I am taking the batch for the Python also. Right now I am also taking the batch for the Oracle. Right now one batch is also going for the .NET and all. What I want to do, suppose we are having the 40 students, what I need to do? I want to get some calculation, like how many students are there from the .NET, how many students are there for the Java, how many students are there for the Python, how many students are there for the Oracle. That I need to do. So what I will do? I will just collect all the Python students and put at one location. I will select all the Java students, mobile number and all, and put at one location. Then I will count, okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So these are the students from the Python. These are the students from the Java. These are the students from the .NET. So group by is what? Group by is basically for the grouping of similar kind of data. Suppose we are in the college. You people are working, like you people are in the BTech computer science. And suppose some people are there from the BTech mechanical. Some people are there from the BTech electronics. I want to count how many students are there from the BTech computer science. How many students are there from the BTech electronics. How many students are there from the other stream and all. So what I need to do? I just need to group the data and finally we can apply the count. So grouping is always applicable for similar kind of data. suppose I'm just going to write, this is the table we are having. We are having the name, job, MGR, hire date, salary, commission, department number. What I want to do, I want to display number of employee as per department. I want to display number of employee as per department. So in department number, like this is the department number we are having. I want to display how many employee are in their department number 10. 1, 2 employee is there for the department 10. How many is for the department 20? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 employee is there from the department 20. How many employee is there from department 30? So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 employees there from the department 30. So how we can do that? So I need to display number of employee as per department. See, department is what? It's a repeating values are there. So what we can do? We can apply the grouping on the department number, and then we can, because we need to count, number of employee means count. So we can apply grouping on the department number and we will apply the count. So how we can write this? I'm just going to write select department number comma count star from EMP, and I'm just going to use group by department number, and we are getting the data like this. In department number 30 we are having the 6 employee, in 20 we are having the 5 employee, in 40 we are having the 1, in 10 we are having 2. Display number of employee as per department. Suppose my question is display number of employee as per job. Oh, like we are having the clerk, we are having the salesman, we are having the manager. I want to display how many salesman is there, how many manager is there, how many analyst is there. So how we can do this? Yes, please, what will be the answer for this? You can write your answer in the chat, or even you can unmute your mic and please respond. What is the answer for this? Yes. Yes, please, what is the answer for this?
Sorry, Santosh, can you repeat the question?
My question is, display number of employee as per job. Got the question?
Yeah.
Like, I want to count how many clerk is there, how many salesman is there, how many managers is there, how many analyst is there, that I need to count. So how we can do this? Yeah, Deepshikha, something is missing. Yes. Yeah, Bhanu, what will be the answer for this? See, what I need to do, I just need to display number of employee as per job. So I'm just going to write select job comma count star from EMP, and finally what we need to use, group by job. This is the answer, just like this previous question. It was as per department and this is as per job. So we are getting like job and we are getting the number of employee. Got my point? Suppose my question is display sum of salary as per department number. How we can do that? I need to display sum of salary as per department number. So basically the question is, I want to get the sum of the salary, like 10. How many employees there? 2. So for 10, the salary is 2450 and 5000. So 5000 plus 2450, 7450. So how we can do this? Select department number, comma. So I'm writing select department number, comma. In the place of count, what we need to do? Sum of cell from EMP and group by. In the group by, what we can do? We can use department number. So for department number 10, 20, 30, 40, we are getting the sum of the salary. Suppose my question is display maximum salary. Maximum salary as per department number. So how we can do this? Yeah, please write your answer in the chat, or just say, or just give me the answer for this. I need to display the maximum salary as per department number. Yeah, how we can do this? Yeah, perfectly fine. Select department number, comma, max of cell from EMP, group by department number. Got this? Now, see, these are basically what exactly we are using: group by department number, group by department number, group by job, group by department number. Tell me one thing, your answer should be either yes or no. I am just going to remove this group by. Will it work for me? Yeah, your answer should be either yes or no. Yeah, Yogesh, what is the answer for this? Deep Sikha is saying no. Okay. Nalamala is saying no.
No, sir.
Oh, that's good, yaar. Everyone is saying no. It's a perfect answer. And why we are not getting this? See the error. Not a single group function. Now we need to understand the fundamental. The fundamental is, if we are using group function, if we are using group function, if we are having multiple columns, if we are having the multiple columns, some column having, if we are having the multiple column, some column having group function, the remaining column must be in group by. Yeah. Once again, just go through with this line. If we are having the multiple column, okay, yes, we are having the multiple column. Some column having the group function, yes, yes, group function is there. The remaining column must be in group by. Oh, we need to apply the group by over here. That's why it's not working. See, just go through with this. If we are having the multiple column, yes, we are having the multiple column. Some column having the group function, yes, we are having the group function. The remaining column must be in group by. Okay, this is the fundamental that you need to remember regarding the group by. Suppose I'm going to write select department number, comma, job. Now what do I need to do from EMP? Now I'm going to write group by department number, comma, job. Now it's working perfectly fine. Oh, that's good. Department number 20, job is clerk, the maximum salary is this. Department number 30, job is salesman, the maximum salary is this. Okay, tell me one thing, if I'm going to remove the group by on job, will it work? Either yes or no, your answer should be in there in chat. If I'm going to remove the group by on job, will it work? That's great. Yeah, yeah, exactly. It's not going to work. It's not going to work. We will get the error. Not a group by expression. not a group by expression. Oh, so I'm just going to use group by job. No, it's working perfectly fine. This is the important thing that you people need to remember. Tell me one thing, I'm going to use select ename comma cell from EMP group by ename, and I'm going to put group by ename. Will it work? No, cell is not there. Either there must be group function or group by. So okay, I'm just going to apply sum of cell. But okay, tell me one thing, I'm going to apply the group by on the ename. Is there any use of that? This is just like you are going to apply the group by, you are just going to make the grouping on the basis of name. How it will work? Like name always, like more or less the name will be the different. If something is different, then how you can apply the grouping? So if I'm going to apply the group by, is basically only applicable for the repetitive columns. Like we are having select a star from EMP. We can apply the group by on job. Repetitive values are there. We can apply the group by on the department number. Repetitive values are there. How we can apply the group by on the employee number? How we can apply the group by on the ename? Because we don't have the repetition of the data. So group by is only applicable for the repetitive data. Otherwise, if you are going to put the group by, there is no any use of that. Now I'm going to write select department number comma job comma sum of cell from EMP. Finally, what we need to use group by department number comma job, and we are getting the data like this. But I also want to display only those record whose sum of the cell is more than 2000. I don't want to display this. I want to display only those record whose sum of the cell is more than 2000. So how we can do that? Yes, please. How we can do that? If I want to display those record whose sum of the cell is more than 2000, so how we can do this? Okay, so we can apply where sum of cell greater than 2000. This is the answer, but this answer is wrong. See the error message. This is not the correct answer. See the message? Group function is not allowed here. Oh, we cannot apply the group function with the where condition. For this purpose, what we can do, we can apply having sum of cell greater than 3000 or the 2000. Oh, this is what exactly the use of having. Got my point? This is what exactly the use of having. We cannot apply the where condition on group function. Group function is not allowed here. Remember, we can't apply group function with where. For this we use having. It's clear? This is the difference between where and having. We can't apply group function with where. For this we use having. Okay, tell me one thing, your answer should be yes or no. I'm just going to write select department number comma job comma sum of cell from EMP. I'm just going to write where salary greater than 2000 group by, or salary greater than 3000 or group by, or 1000 group by department number comma job having sum of salary greater than 2000. Will it work? Yes, what will be your answer? Deep Sikha is saying it's not going to work. Yeah, Ratna from your side. Okay, it's no. Yeah, Bhanu from your side. It's yes or no. Yeah, Yogesh, from your side, it's yes or no?
No, sir.
No, you are wrong. You all are wrong. That's why I'm telling you, just focus on this. See, what is written over there? With where, we cannot apply the group function. It's not mentioning anywhere, like if I'm going to use the where with a group by, it's not going to work. We are not using any group function, it will work. Yeah. Got my point? We can apply the where condition, we cannot apply the group function with where condition. That was the thing. Group function is not allowed here. We can apply the where condition, why not? Clear? So this is really interesting. You people need to remember. Okay, so suppose I'm going to use select department number comma job comma sum of shell from EMP group by department number comma job. Run this. Oh. Now we are having a we are having the extension of the group by, we are having the roll up of department number comma job. So what we are getting over here, we are getting the subtotal of department number 10, we are getting the subtotal of department number 20, we are getting subtotal of department number 30, we are getting subtotal of department number 40, and finally we are getting the grand total. Oh, that's really good. That's really good. But the problem with the roll-up is, it's only going to display the subtotal on department number. It's not going to display the subtotal for the job also. For this purpose, what we can use? We can use cube. Like we are having the sum of the salary. We are having the total according to the job. Like for the clerk it's 4150, for the analyst it's 6000, for the manager it's 8275, for the salesman it's 5600, and for the president it's 5000. And finally we are getting the subtotal for the 10, we are getting for the 20, we are getting for the 30, and we are getting for the 40. So we are having the two extension is there, it's group by roll up and we are having the group by cube. Roll up and cube is basically for the subtotaling. In the group by roll up, it's going to subtotal on the first field. If I'm going to use group by cube, it's going to display the subtotal on the basis of first field as well as the second field. So this is what exactly the select statement is. So now what we are familiar with? We are familiar with the select statement. With the select statement, we can apply the where condition, we can apply order by, we can apply group by, we can apply having. So these things are there. This is the end of the first chapter, how to use the select statement. As such, any problem, any questions from your side, once again we can discuss, that's not an issue. Yes, please. Anything would you like to discuss? Yeah, Deepshikha, please. Exactly. Roll-up is used to get the subtotal for only the first field. By the use of cube, you will get the subtotal on all the fields. Exactly. Yeah, Ratna, any questions from your side? Yeah, Bhanu, दैट्स गुड। Okay, so we can continue with the next. That's good. Now the next command is that we are going to start with. It's about the DDL, DML, and it's about the TCL. DDL stand for Data Definition Language. Data Definition Language. And for this, what we can use? We can use create, these are the command, alter, drop, rename, and truncate. So we are having create, alter, drop, rename, truncate. We are having create, alter, drop, rename, truncate. These are the data definition command. Then we are having the DML. As a DML, data manipulation language. In the data manipulation language, like we are having insert, update, delete. Like we are having the DCL, data control language. Sorry, it's TCL, transaction control language. Transaction control language. Under the transaction control language, what we can use? We can use commit, rollback, and save point. So now we are going to start with these command. First of all, what we need to do to create a new table. If I want to create a new table, what we need to do? The command is create table. Create table. And suppose I'm going to create the table by the name of like create table Sachin, and I'm just going to use employee number is of type number of 4, and I'm going to put the ename over there is of type varchar 2, and I'm also going to use the if some mistake is there in the meantime of typing, what we can use? We can use dot will close the command, and once again you can just continue with this. So I'm just going to use employee number, employee name. I'm going to put salary is of type number of 4. Yeah, the table get created. So I'm just going to use create table, the name of the table. One important thing, like I'm going to create the table Sachin 1, and I'm going to put the employee number, employee name, and again I'm going to put the address is of type varchar 2. In the place of varchar 2, I'm going to use varchar, and suppose I'm going to put the city, and in the place of varchar I'm going to put the care. Oh, that's interesting. And I'm going to put the DOB, date of birth. The table get created. Yeah, the table get created. Remember, for a string, we are having varchar 2. We are having varchar, and we are having char. So someone can ask you the question like, what is the difference between varchar 2, varchar and char? Remember, char is static. Static means what? Suppose I am going to give the size like CT is of type char of 20, and I am going to put the value, it's Delhi. But how many characters is there? It's 5. But still it will hold the 20 spaces. Will hold 20 spaces. It's not going to release the space. Even the value is smaller, it's going to hold the complete entire space. So it's static. And remember, maximum size is 255 character. This is what exactly the char is. In the place of char, we can use varchar or we can use varchar 2. Remember, varchar or varchar 2 is dynamic. Dynamic means what? I am going to put the CT is of type varchar 2. Suppose I am going to give the value Delhi. Will hold 5 spaces and release the remaining. So unnecessary, there will be no any memory consumption, and the maximum size is 4000 character for the varchar 2. Now you can ask me the question like, what is the difference between varchar 2 and varchar? Varchar 2 and varchar, remember, varchar is for old version of Oracle. Varchar 2 is for new version. Earlier the size was 2000 character for the varchar, and varchar 2 is basically for the new version. For new version, and the by default size is 4000 character. Now one important thing. Now if we are writing varchar, it's automatically get converted into varchar 2. So if you are going to give the varchar automatically get converted into varchar 2. Check this. Describe Sachin. See, it was Sachin 1. See, for the city it's char, ename varchar 2, address varchar 2. But we define for the address it was varchar. So this varchar automatically get converted into varchar 2. So we don't need to use the varchar. Now we don't have the varchar, it's varchar 2. But in the earlier version it was there. And this is what exactly the difference between varchar 2 and varchar and char. Got the point? This is how we can create the table. But the thing is that right now this table is blank, nothing is there. So what we can do? We can write select star from Sachin 1. Nothing is there. We don't have the data. What I want to do, I want to insert some values. To insert the values, what we can do, we can write insert into Sachin 1 values. Imply number 1. Imply name is this one, address is this one, city is this one, and this is the date of birth I'm going to give. This is the date format in Oracle. You are inserting the values in all the field, and sequentially you are mentioning the values. Now to insert values in particular field, I want to insert the value in the particular fields. So how we can do that? Insert into Sachin 1, and here I am going to give imply number, and I am going to give the imply name. I am not going to put the salary and all. If you are not going to put the values for all the field, you need to mention the field name. And if I need to insert the value in all the field, if I need to insert the values in all the fields, so in that case what we can use, we can use like this. We don't need to mention the field name. So this is how we can insert the values. Now what we can do, select a star from Sachin 1. These data are there. Once again I want to insert the values. So how we can do that? Once again I need to insert the, write down the command. And once again I want to insert the values. Once again I need to write the command. I don't want to write the command again and again. What we can do? We can use the micro ampersand imply number. I'm just going to use ampersand imply name. This ampersand is known as micro. Run this command. Enter value for imply number. Enter value for imply name. Insert it. And how we can execute the previous command in Oracle? How we can execute the previous command? Slash. Slash is used to execute the previous command. Enter value for imply number. Enter value for imply name. Again slash. This is called micro. This is called micro. And it's not like the micro is only applicable for the insert. We can apply the micro at any location. Select a star from ampersand table name. Enter value for table name, department. So we are getting the data from the department. For the runtime input we can use ampersand. Again run the command. Enter value for table name, emp. Oh, that's really good. I don't need to write the command again and again. I'm just going to use ampersand. So this is called micro. So this is called micro. So my table was select star from Sachin 1. Oh, that's good. So this is how we can create the table. This is how we can create the table. This is how we can insert the values. This is how we can use the micro over there. And one important thing. Suppose I'm going to write select star from EMP. At last we can use semicolon. Perfectly fine. Suppose I'm going to write select star from EMP. Here we can also use the semicolon. Perfectly fine. So you can put the line terminator in the same line or you can put the line terminator in the next line. Suppose I'm going to use select a star from EMP. And here we can use slash also. Slash means what? It just run the command. So it's not only the semicolon, we can also use slash to terminate the program, terminate the line. But we cannot use the slash in the same line. Here we cannot use slash. Here we need to use semicolon only. Yeah, in case of any problem, anytime you can discuss with me, like you can raise your hand, you raise your questions. So as such, any questions from your side? You people are really good, like you are not creating any trouble for me. This is not good. You should ask some question, some atomic kind of questions and all, like something should be there. So please try to find some questions for me also. Oh, you need to solve this question, sir. Do that, otherwise I'm not going to attend the session. Okay, you people are really good. Oh, that's really good for me. Okay, so this is how we can create the table. Now what I want to do, I want to create a table. To create a new table from existing table. Oh, that's great. Or my question is how to copy one table from another table. How to copy from one table to another table. how to copy data as well as a structure. Data as well as structure from one table to another table. Basically, I need to copy the table. How we can do that? This is the command: create table virat as select star from emp. Oh, that's great. I created the virat table from the emp table. Now, if I'm going to write select star from Virat Kohli, this is what exactly we are getting. We are getting employee number, employee name, job, MGR, hire date, salary. Oh, that's great. So the table is coming from the EMP, data is coming from the EMP table. The good thing is everything is just like your EMP table. Yeah. Describe Virat. Oh, it's the same structure with the data and all. It's an interview question. It's an interview question. How to copy data as well as a structure from one table to another table. This is how we can do that. Remember, when we copy the table, it will not copy the constraint. Oh, primary key, unique, not null. These are the constraint. It will not get copied. When we copy the table, it will not copy the constraint. Like in EMP table, employee number is a primary key, but see, in Virat it's not there. Here we are not getting any not null kind of thing. So this is the interesting. And normally someone can ask you this question in the interview: when you copy the table, it will copy the constraint also? No, it will never copy the constraint. Now my question is, how to copy the data as well as a structure of from my question is how to copy a structure of table. Not data. How to copy a structure of table, not data. Oh, how we can do that? I'm just going to write create table Dhoni as select star from EMP where employee number is equal to -1. Oh, that's interesting. As such, there is no any employee number with -1, so it will copy the structure of the table, but we don't have the data. Select a star from Dhoni. This is the interview question. So what we need to do, we just need to put some false condition. We just need to put some false condition. Like this is the false condition I'm going to put. That's good. This is all about the create the table. Now what I want to do, I want to insert data from one table to another table. To insert data from one table to another table, how we can do that? Insert into EMP or Dhoni. Select. Yeah, it's get copied. Select a star from Dhoni. Here we are not using any values and all. We are nothing using. So this is how we can insert the data from one table to another table. We are going to copy the data like this. Select a star from Sachin 1. We don't have the data over here. I want to put some data for this. How we can do that? Update. So what we can do?
Santosh?
Yeah.
Suppose if I want to insert like employee number from 1 to 10,000, like incremental, then how it can be done?
Yeah, we can do that. We can do that. A lot of options are there. For this purpose, we are having the called sequences there that we can manage.
Okay.
Other than the sequence, what we can do, the better option will be we can create the stored procedure over there, and using the stored procedure we can insert the value and it automatically going to increase by one by one. So we are having the different options are there. Either we can use the sequence or we can use the stored procedure, or other option is also there, like we can use the label. So we are having two, three options are there.
Okay.
Yeah, I will show that. Okay. So now what I need to do, I need to update the value. Like I need to put the values over here. So how we can do that? Update Sachin 1, set ADDR is, like I'm going to give Bangalore, and I'm just going to put here employee number is equal to 11. Yeah, now it's Bangalore. At the time of update, one important thing we need to remember, if I'm not going to put the where condition, then what will happen? Oh, it will get updated for the entire table. Oh, that's great. Remember, with the update command and the delete command, always you need to put the where condition. If you are not going to give the where condition, it will get updated for the entire table. That's what we are getting. Now what I'm going to do, I'm just going to write update Sachin 1, set ADDR is equal to Bangalore, comma. For the multiple values we can put like this. Address is equal to Bangalore, suppose city is equal to Yahoo. Where employee number is 11. Now it's Yahoo. So we can put the multiple values for this. So this is how we can use the update command. At the time of update, you just need to remember like how to put the values and all. Now, what we can do, we can delete the values also. Like I'm going to use delete. Delete from Sachin 1, where employee number is 64. Delete from Sachin 1 where employee number is equal to 64. Oh, that's great. This particular record get deleted. So this is how we can apply the delete command. Now if I'm not going to do this, I'm not going to put the where condition, then all these records get deleted. This is not good. Suppose you are working in the company and you are going to write down the command like this, believe me, next day the termination letter will be there with you. So don't do this kind of mistake in any company. Like if you are going to apply the update command, if you are going to apply the delete command, every time you need to think about the where condition. Every time you need to put the where condition. If I'm going to apply the delete, if I'm going to apply the update, always we need to think about the where condition. It's clear. Insert, update, delete, create. Now this was my table. I want to add some field. Oh, mobile number is not there, it must be. So I need to add the field. To add fields, alter table Sachin, add mobile is of type number, like this. Oh, by mistake I put 4. How the mobile number can be of 4 character? It should be the 10 character. So I need to modify alter table name, modify mobile number is of type 10. Oh, now if I'm going to put the size, see the size, it's a 10. what I want to do, I want to rename this. So what we can do, we can apply alter table table name, and we are going to use rename mobile to phone. So I'm just going to apply alter table table name, rename column. Column keyword is there. So now it's phone, it's not mobile. I want to drop this column. Alter table table name, drop. Alter table table name, drop column. And the name of the column. Column is what? It's a phone. Alter table table name, drop column, column name. Oh, we don't have. So basically, if I want to make the changes with the structure of the table, we can apply the alter command. Alter table table name, add. Alter table table name, modify. Alter table table name, rename. Alter table table name, drop. So this is the command that we can apply over here. Now, this is my table. Select a star from EMP or select a star from section 1. Oh, it's get deleted. Okay, suppose this is my table. What I'm going to do, I'm going to delete the record. Delete from EMP. All the data get deleted. Oh, nothing is there. Do one thing, apply the rollback. Oh, it's get back. It's get back. So the rollback command, by the use of rollback command, you can undo. Now, one command is there. It's more dangerous. And that command is truncate. Truncate table EMP. Nothing is there. Apply the rollback. Oh, we can't roll back now. But table is there. After the truncate, data get removed permanently. But table is there. I also remove the table. Oh, drop table table name. Drop table EMP. The most dangerous command that we can apply. Now nothing is there. No, we don't have the table. We don't have the... nothing is there. So what I'm trying to say, like we are having the three options. One is delete. Delete will delete the record. Will delete all data, all record. In delete we can put the condition. Can put condition and can be roll back. After the delete, it can be roll back. So delete will delete all data. In the delete we can put the condition. And after the delete, it can be roll back. We are having the truncate. We delete all data. Can't put condition. Oh, in truncate we can't put condition. Where condition is not allowed. And can't we roll back. But in both, table will be there. Table will be there. So it's less dangerous. At least table will be there. Now, the drop. Table get removed. Table get removed. Can't roll back. Can't roll back. Table get removed. Can't roll back. So it's more dangerous now. So this is the guaranteed question for your every interview. What is the difference between delete, drop and truncate? Delete, drop and truncate. Remember, after the delete you can apply the rollback, but after the drop and truncate we can't apply the rollback. In the delete we can put the condition. For the drop and truncate we can't put the condition. After the truncate data will get removed but table will be there. After the drop everything get removed. So this is what exactly the delete, truncate and drop is. One command is there, we are having the rename. So we can apply rename department to department. Oh, table get rename. So now we don't have dept, we have CPT. Select star from CPT. So this is how you can rename the table. So this is rename table. Tell me one thing. This is my table. And I want to change this. I want to change this. How we can do that? I want to delete this. How we can do that? What will be the command to delete this accounting? What will be the command to delete this accounting? Yeah, any suggestions? Yes. Yeah, Ratna, any suggestion? Yeah, Deepsika. Yogesh.
I mean, we can pass employee number there.
Okay. Okay. Yeah, Yogesh and Bhanu. Yeah. Your answer is perfectly wrong.
Sorry, you can update the dename to null wherever the department.
Exactly. Exactly. This is the answer.
Because delete entire row will be deleted.
Exactly. Got it. We can apply update. Update EMP. Set dename is equal to null where department number is equal to 10. This is the answer. Update CPT, the table name. Yeah. Remember, insert means always new record. Update means always old record. If I need to make any modifications with old record, we will go with the update. Delete means always the existing record you need to delete. Means old record we are talking about. And alter is about the change structure of table. So this is the important thing that we need to remember. Got the point? So you people need any break? Yeah, you people require the break for the 5 minutes? Okay, so it's not from you people's side. So okay, we should continue. So now we are familiar with create, alter, drop, rename, truncate, all the DDL command. We are familiar with insert, update and delete. Now the next is we are having the concept of TCL, transaction control language. Transaction control language. In the transaction control language, we are having the commit, rollback, and save point. Commit, rollback, and save point. First of all, we need to understand what exactly the transaction is. Transaction means what? Remember, transaction begin or end with commit or rollback. Commit or rollback. Transaction begin or end with commit and rollback. Suppose, remember, transaction means suppose I'm going to apply insert and I'm going to apply the commit. Again I'm going to apply insert, I'm going to apply update, and I'm going to apply rollback. Suppose I'm going to apply delete, and I'm going to put the commit, update, and then again I'm going to apply the commit. Remember, from this point to this point it's a one transaction, and from this point to this point it's another transaction, and from this point to this point it's another transaction. Remember, commit is, first of all, commit is basically for the save. Commit is basically for save. Rollback is basically for undo. Number one. Number two, commit and rollback having impact on DML only. Commit and rollback having impact on DML only. Means after insert and update and delete, you are going to make the commit, there will be impact. If you are going to make the commit and rollback after create and alter, nothing will happen. Suppose I am going to apply, this is the table we are having. This is how we can see the list of the table. Oh, lot of table are there. These are the list of the tables. Suppose what I want to do, we are having the country table, suppose. So, or other table will be there, like we are having imp copy table. I'm just going to write select a star from imp copy. These are the data we are having. I'm just going to put delete from emp imp copy. If I'm going to write select, nothing is there, but at the same time I'm going to open the another Oracle SQL Plus, and here I'm going to write connect Scott/Tiger, and here I'm going to put select a star from emp copy. Oh, this data is there. What is this? Here we are not getting, like, we are getting no row selected because you are in the middle of the transaction. It's not get committed. Once it's get committed, now I'm going to apply the commit. Now it's become permanent. If I'm going to write select command over here, we are not getting anything. So commit means you are going to make it permanent, whatever the insert, update or delete. And rollback means you are going to make it undo. So this is the important thing that we need to remember. It's a commit and a rollback. Suppose, remember, we can't make a rollback after the commit. So suppose we are having the another table, like imply table we are having. Select we are like imply. Like imply table we are having. What I'm going to do, I'm going to delete the record. Delete from imply. Oh, by mistake it's get deleted. We can apply the rollback immediately. And it get rollback. Again apply the rollback. Apply the select statement over there. The data get back. So this is what exactly the commit and rollback is. Remember, commit and rollback having impact on insert, update, delete only. There is no impact of commit on rollback on create, alter, drop, rename, truncate. There is no any impact of that. So commit and rollback is basically, it's a transaction control language. And what exactly the transaction is? Insert, update, delete. Tell me one thing. suppose I'm going for the bank, and in the bank I'm going to deposit some amount in my account, in bank I'm going to withdraw some amount. That's basically a transaction. And suppose we are going in the bank and some bank manager is there and he is my friend and I'm going to meet with him. This is not a transaction. I'm not going to make any transaction with my account. I'm just going over there just to meet my friend who is the manager in the bank. So once you are going to the bank, it's not a transaction. Basically the transaction is you are going to withdraw some amount, you are going to deposit some amount in your account. That's the transaction. The same thing, transaction is always insert, update, delete, insert, update, delete. And commit and rollback is what? If I want to make it permanent, it will be commit. Like if you are inserting the value, insert, 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 and you are going to make it commit, now it will be permanent, then it will be, other user can view this. If I'm going to write like delete, 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 after the delete, if I'm going to perform commit, then it will be not visible to the other user. So commit and rollback is only having the impact on insert, update, delete. The other command as such, there is no any impact of the commit and rollback. Got the point? So if someone is going to ask you, if I'm going to drop the table, after dropping the table, if I'm going to apply the rollback, what will happen? After dropping the table, I'm going to apply the rollback, what will happen? Nothing will happen. Because drop is what? It's a DDL command. And commit and rollback having impact on insert, update, delete only. So as such, there is nothing will happen. This is what exactly the commit and rollback, insert, update, delete and all. Now, one important thing. Like I'm going to delete this record. Like I'm going to delete the record called ID less than 1000. I'm just going to delete from employee where ID less than 1000. 5 row deleted. Now I'm just going to apply the save point. I'm going to write delete from where ID greater than 1000. If I'm going to apply the rollback, what will happen? Yes, please, what will happen? Both the delete will get rollback, but I don't want to rollback this. I only want to rollback this. So what we can do, we can apply a rollback to A. Now if I'm going to write the select statement, see, these record get rollback, but these record not get rollback. Why? Because you are using rollback to A up to the save point. So basically save point is in the middle point basically. You are just making to rollback up to this point. So above this, it's not going to make the rollback. That's why we are using rollback to save point. It's clear? So now we are familiar with insert, update, delete, create, alter, drop, rename, truncate, commit, rollback and save point. And before that it was the group by and group function was there. Group by and group function. And before that it was the select statement. So these are the lot of topics are there now. You people initially just need to do the practice and then only we will continue. It's not like that. Suppose again if I'm going to cover the new topic, it's again the overflow will be there. So I don't want to do that. Whatever the topic we are covering in the session, it should get completed from your side. Then only there is the benefit of doing all these exercise and all. And right now you people are on such a stage, you just need to do the practice right now. Lot of questions will be there after the subqueries and joins. So after this what we need to start with, after this I need to start with the next chapter. It's a constraint. like primary key, foreign key, unique, not null, check, default. These things are there that I need to start. But I will start this chapter on the next day, means tomorrow. Initially, you people just need to do the practice with all these basic command, because this one is the important one, and we can't ignore any command like all. So what I'm going to do, I'm just going to make it spool off the first thing. So I will just send this file in the WhatsApp group, and from that particular group you can get this file. Number one. Number two, there was some suggestion, and the suggestion was from Vanu, like our batch is, it's on Saturday and Sunday. Can we do one thing like plus Saturday and Sunday plus, we can go with the batch on Wednesday or on Thursday in the evening. So at least there will be three sessions in the week. So again, the class sessions will get completed earlier. And again, see, Saturday, Sunday, again, it's a gap of 6 days. So in between, what we can do one session either on Thursday or Wednesday for 1 hour. It's not more than that. It's 1 hour, it's more than sufficient. And around 5:30, around 5 to 6 or 6 to 7, that we can do. Can we do that?
Yes, Santosh.
See, I don't have the problem with the timing. So if you people tell me like whatever the timing is suitable for you, I can continue with that. If you are looking for the regular batch, I can go with the regular batch even. If you are looking for the alternate batch, we can go with the alternate batch. Otherwise, Saturday and Sunday is already going on. On Wednesday, we can put the batch for the 1 hour. That will be better. And the batch timing will be, it's around 5 to 6 or 5:30 to 6:30 in the evening. So as such, there is no any problem with that. Yeah, everyone is fine with this.